Who wants some smoked picanha on the Blaze Kamado?
You ready? Let's go!
What's going on, everybody? So today I'm going to be doing something that I have done previously, taking a little break from the sous vide journey to basically do a picanha. We'll be doing this on the Blaze Kamado rotisserie style. I've done this a couple times before. You may have seen a previous video. I'll add the links above so you can see it. I'm gonna do something a little bit different with this one. We're gonna dry brine it a little bit before we cook it today. So let's get into it and let's have some fun. So for the dry and brine process, it's just a matter of using coarse salt, kosher salt. That's what I like to use. I love the picanha cut for a lot of different reasons. Just one simply being the fat cap that protects it while it's being cooked, and as it renders, it obviously keeps this thing moist overall. And then the smoked flavor that comes through on this cut is absolutely amazing. This is definitely one of my favorite cuts from Quarter Road. If you haven't done so, check them out. You can see it's got a very nice large fat cap, which I will score eventually, just not now for this process, because right now I'm just trying to basically get the moisture as much as I can to pull out of here with the dry brining process. So let's get this salted up and go from there. Just basically take a paper towel to get some of the moisture off of here, and then after I do that, basically we'll start salting this up. Once I've salted it up, I'm basically gonna put this into the refrigerator, allow that to rest, allow the salt to kind of pull out some of the moisture. And like I said, definitely should be a good cook. And don't worry, the salt is not gonna make the meat overly salty, because it will come off. And most of this will either penetrate into the meat and be absorbed, but it's not going to be over too much. It's not going to be over salty. But like I said, I'm just basically salting this up. And this is an awesome way just to basically do a quick dry brine on a cut of meat. And it works out pretty good. So I'm gonna go ahead, get this into the refrigerator, let that set, and we'll get the smoker rolling a little bit later, and we should have an excellent meal. I'm also planning on making some sauce to go along with this. It's one of my favorites, so stay tuned for that. Should be a good cook. First things first, I've already wiped off the dry brine on this picanha. Next, it's time to score the fat cap. And the reason I'm scoring the fat cap is essentially it's going to allow this fat to render a little faster on the back of this. And honestly, I just think it gives it a good presentation. But yeah, this is basically what I'm doing. When I score the fat cap, I'm not going all the way down into the meat. Just enough to where it gets deep into the fat tissue. Okay, now that I've done that, I'm just going to basically go crossways now. Almost like a checker pattern. Alright, so you can kind of see all the scoring on that fat cap. Now I'm going to get it seasoned up. I'll start with this side. First, I'm gonna be using this Brazilian steakhouse blend from Guste Vite. For obvious reasons, picanha, Brazilian, kinda goes together. So, get that all in there on that side. And flip this over and get this side. I've tried the seasoning already. It's done well so far on the cuts of steak that I've used it on, so don't think it'll be any different for this cut either. Next, I have this salt-free and sugar-free steak seasoning from Guste Vite. It's a little bit chunkier, but it's got a nice flavor to it as well. And I think it's just gonna add that much more depthness to the steak. So put this on there. Make sure we get all this. All right, I'm gonna let that rest for just a minute, set into that, and then we'll get this on the skewer, get it on the smoker. All right, so I've gotten this on the skewer after it's rested for a little bit. For this skewer, I always have to keep these tight, usually using pliers to basically tighten this up. But as you can see, I got this on there. I've got it speared down here, kind of all four points almost. And this side is just more of a security to keep it from rolling. Let's get this onto the cooker and go from there. Yeah, the beauty of this Blaze Kamado is that it has basically a rotisserie system that's built for it. So it's real easy to use. You can see basically this is center. Basically I'm going to obviously be smoking this around 300 degrees, keeping the meat really centered on this, right in line with the charcoal. I'll show you what this looks like from a side standpoint, and then we can go from there. You can see, basically, you got this interlocking rod system that basically attaches to the skewer. Over here, you can kind of see that it's got a little bit of a bracket internally, which is nice because it doesn't require any additional adapters like some other Kamados. Basically, you can see the Prime 6 charcoal with the little post oak back there rolling. Definitely look forward to seeing how this turns out. We're going to be smoking this at 300. Probably for a little over an hour and a half. We'll see how this works out and go from there. Okay, I'm going to be making another chimichurri recipe. Basically, this is your Italian parsley. This is cilantro, white onion. I'm also going to be using a little bit of red bell pepper. That is black garlic. Also, a little bit of red pepper flakes along with some oregano. Also, a little dash of honey. Also, extra virgin olive oil and red wine vinegar. So let's get into it. Nicely right now, we're setting around 82 to 84 degrees internal temp on the picanha. Still a ways to go. That color's coming through nicely though. Cannot wait to see how this turns out, so stay tuned. Basically at that done range, I'm hitting around 135, 136 depending on where you probe this. I'm gonna let it tin it up, set it off to the side, and then we'll go ahead and slice it up. So it's moment of truth, a little bit of slice of this picanha. See how it turned out. So I obviously have some of that chimichurri on top of there, as you can see. All I can say, mission accomplished. This definitely turned out like an excellent cook. Certainly enjoyed this. Always enjoyed picanha on the rotisserie, and it was a fun cook. Don't forget that subscribe button. Hit those notifications if you want to see more fun cooks like this coming up in the future, along with some other fun experiments. Until such time, good cooking.